Hello there, and thank you so much once again for joining us for our weekly business roundup. My name is Violet Sasia. We shall be talking about events that have made headlines throughout the week and also trying to make sure that you stay within the news and know what to do as a business person. Joining me today is Paul Busharizi, that is a business editor and a veteran journalist here with The New Vision. So Paul, the NSSF is being looked into, as we saw this week, and the committee that is looking into mismanagement of funds at the NSSF found out that 1.8 billion shillings was allocated to the corporate social responsibility. And also we saw something about the probe going further to ask questions about the 11 billion shillings going to 20 billion that was given out to Uganda Clays. So what are your comments on this and what stood out for you from the probe?
Yeah, well, my understanding from what I've heard from the reports is 1.8 billion was for corporate social responsibility to be distributed between the chairman and some board members and stuff like that. And I also learned that the figure was actually much lower, but then these increases came in, and this is a new thing with the new board. So it was kind of depressing or disappointing that they could use our money, workers' money, so casually. I mean, 1.8 in the greater scope of things of NSSF is not much, but still, you know, small things grow into big things, so we're concerned about that.
Now, the central bank did announce that it was going to keep the same lending rate and also said that inflation is not going to ease up anytime soon. So this has also been felt by at least myself as a Ugandan. And you can tell that that directly impacts us. However, we need it to be broken down in our simple terms to understand what really this means for us, especially knowing that inflation will not be, you know, going down anytime soon. We last heard it was it had moved from 10.2 to 10.4, and hearing such news can be quite devastating. So what do you think about it?
I think we felt this. I mean, we felt this from last year that inflation is not going to go away very quickly. For one thing, coming out of COVID, some production had stopped. So inflation, by definition, is too much money chasing too few goods. Now, to the extent that that production are not recovered from COVID means that there's too much money chasing too few goods. That's one thing. But secondly, the inflation is imported inflation. It's coming from outside Uganda, caused by partly by the war in Ukraine and the hangover from COVID. So we know in the world that is not about to go. So you could see that inflation is going to affect us for a while. But also, interestingly, around this time, you know what's happening. It's school time. People are having to pull out money to pay school fees. Schools are stocking up on food. So you can imagine, you know, for the last 2 months when schools were out, you know, in theory, there was food. But now the schools are, you know, stacking it up. And that's causing a shortage of food and hence the inflation. Also, we know that Kenya's president, new president William Ruto, has kind of opened up the market to Ugandan goods again. In the last years, we were struggling with maize not going to Kenya, eggs not going to Kenya, milk not going to Kenya, and a host of other things. So now that the market in Kenya is open, you can imagine that scarcities are created on this side. Because as a farmer or as a trader, the prices are better in Kenya than here.
Now, the tourism sector received good news after Uganda was declared Ebola-free by the World Health Organization and the Ministry of Health. So, however, I'm concerned, you know, a little bit, and maybe other Ugandans, is our tourism sector running on the presence or the absence of diseases, pandemics, epidemics? If, for example, we had, you know, an epidemic for the next 5 years or six, God forbid, would we see no tourism sector in Uganda, or are there ways that we can actually boost the sector without having to wait for interruptions such as this?
I think the tourism sector's model has been to attract tourists from the outside in. But COVID has showed them, I hope they've learned the lesson, that they need to build local demand. Many people in this country fly out of this country to go touring, and they've never been to all our tourist sites, which is just, I mean, and they spend money in Dubai, in Dar es Salaam, even in Nairobi, in Mombasa, just around the corner, Zanzibar, and they spend probably more money than they would spend here. So they need, I think the tourism industry really needs to think about, beyond paying lip service, how can it get more Ugandans traveling this country? And that will help them to survive the bad times. Because as you said, We had COVID, put them down for a year or two. No sooner have you recovered from COVID Ebola, and you can bet your last shilling that within the next 2 years, there'll be something else that's going to come that's going to dissuade foreign tourists. So they really need to think about it. If they are not, then, you know, I wonder how much lessons they need to take before they take this lesson.
Okay, that's it from Oil and Gas. So thank you so much once again for making time. We shall catch up soon for more details coming in from the world of business. Thank you very much. And dear viewer, thank you so much once again for making time. This is why we come to you every week with events coming from the world of business. We want to make sure that you stay in the loop of events happening in the economy. And we shall see you next time. My name is Vaila Kusasira. For now, back to the news.